Hi everyone, welcome back. In this presentation, I am going to talk about how to upload a question from Word document to our Moodle LMS. So you prepare your questions in the Word document, and whatever the choices, just you keep all the questions. And like this, so question number one, true or false, question number two, again true or false, question number three, some multiple choice question, question number four, multiple choice question, question number five, some multiple choice questions. So this is the sample, okay? So now this Word document, now we are going to upload into our Moodle LMS for our quiz purposes. So for that, what we need to do, so we need to convert this Word document into ordinary text format, right? We need to convert these questions into the text format. So for that, what we need, just copy all the questions and paste it into any of the notepad. Just I'm opening the notepad, just open the notepad. Paste it into the notepad. Now questions are pasted. Now after once questions are pasted, now we need to do the small work here. What we need to, just we need to remove this question number one, and these choices as well we need to remove. So question number two, and here, and remove all the questions from the your question. Just we need to keep only the question and the related choices. Now after that, we are going to give the which one is right answer, which one is the wrong answer, we are going to specify here. For that, what we need to do, and we need to do that the small symbols we need to add before the right answers. For an example, so this is the one question. So is Python case sensitive when dealing with the variables, true or false? Now in this true or false, so we need to specify which one is right answer, which one is wrong answer. For the reason, we are going to use some special symbols, right? And this is very easy, as well as you don't want to type one by one questions in the Moodle. Just to add the some symbols, just attach the file and it will be reflected in your Moodle LMS. So what are the special symbols we are going to use it here? So now just go to your choices. In the choices, now what we need to do, you need to add some special symbols right now. So now open a curly braces, okay, open a curly braces, and after that use the tilde mark, okay, and percentage. And for an example, if this answer is a right answer, just put the 100%. That's all. Okay. So this is the right answer. Now come to the second option. In the second option, suppose this answer is a wrong answer. Again, what you need to do, just to copy this from the tilde to up to the percentage, copy it and paste it here. Now what is meaning? This is a wrong answer, just put the 0%. But don't forget it, you need to give that along with this percentage, tilde mark, percentage, 0%. That is a very important, don't forget it. You need to specify with the this one. You need to specify along with the tilde mark. So tilde mark and the percentage 0 and percentage symbol you need to specify. Finally, just close this curly braces. Okay, now it means that the answer is true is a correct answer and false is the wrong answer. Now for this one, suppose again open a curly braces, tilde mark, and just copy paste, otherwise just copy paste it from here, right, and paste it. And suppose this answer is wrong answer, just 0%. And now the second one is right answer, just here, come here, then this is 100%. Now the answer is false is right answer, just let us assume, just close the curly braces. So now true or false. Now come to this this question. Suppose the third question. In the third question, all keywords in Python are in some four choices are there. Now in that four choices, only one choice is the right answer. Remaining choices are the wrong answer. For that, what is that we need to, how to specify it, and we need to specify like this. Just I will show. So we need to specify like this. How it is specified? See here and see here, and we need to specify like this. So here only the wrong answer is the last answer is the right answer. See, 100% remaining all are 0%, tilt 0%, tilt 0%. So that this is the last answer is the right answer. Okay, this is the only one right answer. So let us assume, suppose in our question there are two answer we are going to give. So right there we are going to give the two answer for the, so two answer is a, one answer is a 50%, another answer is another 50%. For this example, see this example, which of the following is invalid? See, this is the wrong answer complete. Now so listen here, 50%, then another answer is also 50%. It means that so 50-50, so the participant need to choose the two answers, right? Then only the students will get the full mark, otherwise 50 mark only. The so 50%, 50, there are two choices, the multiple choices answer for this question. Okay, now come to the third question. So what is the third question? So the last question is, check the cities of the, for an example, Sultanate of Oman. Now let's imagine, suppose you feel that your choices is going to have that two choices are the right answer. You are going to give the 100% in the sense, if anyone the students going to choose the answer will be the right answer, full answer. For that, what it, so you need to give that 100% and 100%. Just there is a difference is there. What is the difference between these questions and this is the student 50%, this is a 50% answer, this is a 50% answer. For this one, either this and this both are right answers, because 100%, 100%. So here not only 50, 100, you can give 25%, you can give 75%, or you can give that 35%, 65%, that's up to you. You need to specify how much percentage you are going to give that particular choice. Accordingly, the mark weightage will be distributed to among the choices. Okay. So now, this is the text file. Now what we are going to do, just we need to save this file as text file, save. Just I am going to save this file as ordinary text file. Okay, just save the file, that's all. Now this file only we are going to call in our Moodle LMS. So shall we go to our Moodle LMS? So this is our Moodle. In this Moodle, now we are going to create a one quiz. So add a quiz, just add the quiz. Okay, the question is now the quiz is adding now. Just I am going to add quiz one. Okay, timing, grade, these are all you need to specify it and save and return to the course. Now here I am going to add the questions, whatever questions we prepared in our text file. So I am going to enter into the this quiz one. Just click the quiz one and see, no questions have been added yet. Now we are going to add the questions. Now just go to this gear symbol, come down there, you will find the import option. Now we are going to import the questions from the question, that is from the text file, a word file. So import. Now one here, it's a very important, this option is the most important. In this option, what we need to choose, we need to choose an option for GIFT format. Now you need to choose option GIFT format, and now we need to specify it. And if you see the general, where in the general, so where you are going to keep, we are going to keep it in the quiz one. So all the questions will be transferred to this quiz one. So just choose the category. Which category do you want to save your question bank, right? Choose the file or drag and drop. So what I am going to do, just I am going to drop the file. So which file? Otherwise choose the file, and I am going to choose the file. Choose the file and desktop. I am keeping that here. This file I'm going to show this one, and the question paper txt. Okay, in that question paper txt this is a question paper txt. Now finally just upload this file. Okay, now file is uploading, right? Now just for a few minutes your file is uploading one by one. So now the file is uploaded, just import it. Now what is showing? Now see the questions, whatever questions are there, the questions are uploaded. Now continue, right? Shall we see that? See the questions, all the questions are uploaded here. And with this, if you want to see the preview, now this is a question. Now this questions, what we are going to do, this questions we are going to attach in our quiz one. Just go to the again the quiz. Okay, we need to add the quizzes. Go to quiz one. Still that no questions added. Now we are going to add those questions into this quiz one. Edit quiz. Add. Press add from the question bank. Okay, choose the question bank. So where it is you are going to. So already we added where this category, we added quiz one category. Now questions are displayed. Choose all the questions. So if you want to the particular question, choose a particular question, add it. Or you want to add all the questions, just choose all the questions, add it to the questions. So now questions are added here. See the whatever questions we prepared. You can, if you want to see that preview, just go to the preview and see the questions. The questions are added here. Now just I want to show one thing here. Now so for this question, all keywords, now if you open the all the questions, it will show, sorry, the just open the preview. If you open the all the question, the all the questions, it will show it as square box, right? Like a multiple choices question. But some questions are we fixed as true or false. True or false in the sense we need to specify the choose either this or that. So for that, what we need to do, so we need to suppose we need to see, is Python case sensitive in dealing with this question? We know very well this question is the true or false questions. For that, just go to this question, edit question, okay, and come down there, you will find. So by default all the questions will be stored as a multiple answers alone. Just go to here, choose answer anyone, or you right, and just save changes. After save changes, now see the question. Now if you see the question, it will show it as like this square, this circles only. It will not come like a square type. Now for the another one more thing I would like to inform now. And if you click the question, now here some choices are coming. A, B is coming, right? And you also want that, you don't want to show this A, B also, you want to remove it. That is also option is available. Go to again here, right? And come down. Now here what you need to do, you need to choose this only one answer, and numbers of choices use no numbering, right? If you choose this no numbering, what will happen? Now your questions, your choices will be displayed only that with the circle without A, right? If you go to the any multiple choice questions, suppose if it is a multiple choice questions, right? And if you multiple choice question, A, B, C is there. If you don't want to show this A, B, C, D, just go there and remove that no numbering, and right, just is finished. Now another one more thing, shall we see this one? This question is only one answer, sir. See, choice one none, choice two none, choice three none, and choice four and 100%. In the this question is only one answer question. Better if only one answer question, why you choose this multiple? Better choose only one answer question and save, right? Now, shall we go to the another question? Just we will change it. Suppose if this is the question, if this question, and if this question, this question 50%, see the first choice is none, second choice 50%, and third choice none, and fourth choice is 50%. This question has two choices. The participant need to select two. So this is a multiple choice question. So you keep it the multiple choice, and just if you want to remove this one, just remove it and save the thing, and now it will show it as the multiple choice question. So like that, this is once after upload the question, this small operational work we need to do to make that our questions in that in the professional way to the participants. Just here this one I change, you know, shall we see this one? See, with I removed ABC, only choices only showing. When you see here mathematical operation, only now only the true or false is only showing. When you go to the this program, check, and now it will come with the square bracket. Okay, it will show, I'll show that 100%, 100%. So this question is as 100%, 100%. See here, the first choice is 100%, second choice is none, third choice is 100%. So this is the, so the student if choose any one answer right here, this is one sample. Okay, this is a multiple choice questions, and okay, so this is the way we can manage, we can upload the questions from the Word document to where, from Word document to the our question bank. Well, now let us see our questions. Okay, how it is showing in our question. Just go to our course. Now there, just go to quiz, see that preview, and see this is our whatever questions we uploaded, then questions are displayed in that the particular quiz. The similarly the students also will get this questions, right? So this is a very simple, and now just I want to show this one. And now apart from this one, there is a small thing I would like to add now. Just go to again the quiz, just edit the quiz. Okay, this is the quiz, edit quiz. Now if you want to divide the portions, right, you want to divide the portions, what is the meaning of divide the portions? In the sense sections, you keep it as a section. Set of questions belongs to one section, set of questions belongs to another section. How to prepare this section, right? So for that, what we need to do, so when you see here, add showing, right? And if you see here, there is a one more, so here one more question is, so a new section heading, how to, this is the section heading giving for the set of questions. Just choose this section heading, now give this, for an example, I'm giving multiple choice questions. Okay, just enter it. Now for this one, this is a true or false question. See here, edit heading, here give that this is a true or false questions, right? This is a true or false questions. So now there are now two sections are there. Suppose if you want to add the true or false questions only for this section, just go to add and choose the question bank, and now you prepare the set of questions for the true or false, just upload the true or false question for this section. Suppose you prepare the multiple choice questions, the set of questions, and the separate file is there, and go here again, so go here again, add the question bank, so that, so accordingly then the file will be separated and it will be attached to the particular thing. Now if you want to, suppose you want to add the separate question, for an example, go to add the third one. The first add belongs to the first section, this second add belongs to the second section, and the third add is, it's a separate. Now for this one, just we are going to add one essay type questions, add essay type questions directly. I am going to add this quiz one also, just for write short note on for example COVID-19, right? Just the people need to, this is the questions, so question text. Now how you are going to give the plain text, and how many lines you want to just keep it everything and save it. So now see that now the third pages it will show that only one question. So according you need to change your mark as well. Let us see that how it is showing in that preview. Just how is the preview getting? Similarly, your student will get it. Okay. Now maybe I will go to again just third section also. We'll keep that name. Okay. So better now. That's good practice now. Just I'm going to give the name for this one. Edit name. I am giving the name for this new heading. What is this one? Essay type questions. Okay. Enter it. Now just go to here. See the preview. Quiz one. Just preview the question. See here. This is a true or false question. And this is a multiple choice question. And this is an essay type question. The first, the true or false, the student will get the first three questions true or false. The next page, it will get the multiple choice question, and third page essay type. So three section wise we are dividing, and even the this multiple choice question you can keep it in the every page wise. That is also possible. So you can, so this is the way we can arrange our questions for our students. Okay, thank you very much. Thanks for watching.